Click the bell icon to get latest videos from Ikeda.
Hello friends, I welcome you all to this video. We are with morphological image processing. We are understanding the morphological image processing operations like the dilation, erosion, opening, closing, the various properties we have seen for them, and also proved these properties with the help of MATLAB environment also. Now we are dealing with the various applications that can be possible with the help of these fundamental operations. After these operations, the helpful algorithm, that is the hit or miss transformation, is also there. And further, we moved with the help of the boundary extraction, the region filling, the thickening we are covered with, the extraction of the connected components from the binary image is also possible. Now let us address the another one, that is skeletons. So here we start with our topic, and for continuation into the skeletons, we take the figure help, and here we represent a skeleton with the help of S in the bracket A for the set A that has been very intuitively simple here. So in this figure you find the four portions here. So part A that has been represented onto the left hand side top portion here is the exact set A here. Now in the figure part B, on its right hand side, we find the various positions represented marked with the circles at the corners so that we can find the skeleton. Now in the part C here, the maximum disc with the centers onto the skeleton of the A we can represent, and the another maximum disc onto the different segment of the skeleton A is there, and finally a complete skeleton is represented with the dashed line here. Now from this figure we can deduce few of the points. So very first of all, if Z is the point of the skeleton represented S of A, and D suffix Z is the largest disc centered at Z and contained into the set A, one cannot find a larger disc. So it is not necessarily centered at the position of the Z only. So it can be containing D suffix Z and included into the capital A, the set. Now the disc represented D suffix Z is called as the maximum disc. The disc D suffix Z will touch all the boundaries of the set capital A represented at the two or more different places. Now the skeleton of capital A can be expressed in the terms of erosion operation and the opening operation, the extensions to the dilation and erosion. So therefore we can show it as S of A. Here the operation will extend from K is equal to 0 to capital K for S suffix K of A here. So this is with S suffix K of capital A obtained by, here we have the first parenthesis where we find the erosion of capital A by the K times the structuring element, or the K as B we shall be discussing here, minus here we again have the erosion and the opening operation with the structuring element B here. Here the B represent as usual the structuring element, and the first parenthesis indicates that we have to find the erosion but K times successively here. So the representation of the K times successive erosions can be like this here. So we find the erosion of A by B, the intermediate result that we obtained, we again find the erosion, we again find the erosion up to the K successive steps. So K times and the capital K will be the last iterative step to represent here. Before that, the set A erodes with the empty set. So the last one is to be excluded here. So the remaining will be nothing but the skeleton here. So in the another type of mathematical representation, here we can have the capital K represented as the max for the operation representing the K here with A eroded by K successive B will not be equal to null that has been represented by this phi here. Now, the formulation that we have just now represented in these two equations for representation of the skeleton S of A can be obtained as the union of the skeleton subsets represented S suffix K for the subsets K is equal to 1, 2, 3. We can go on for the input set A here. Also, it can be shown that the capital A can be reconstructed from the subsets by using the equation, that is A is equal to, we have the union operation K ranging from 0 to capital K, and here we have the dilation operation in successive formation here. So here the successive dilations are represented into the parenthesis for S suffix K of A with the structuring element used capital B here. So this is the successive dilation operation. We find SK of A first of all, then we find the dilation. The dilated result is again dilated by the same structuring B up to the capital K step here. So let us have the use of the figure that illustrates this concept here. So we have all these figures into the tabulation form. Here for K is equal to 0, 1 and 2, we have the representations. In the first column, the K values have been given. So it follows by the successive erosion of A and then the opening of the erosed version by the structuring element B here. The skeleton we represent for the subsets here. We find the union operation for small k is equal to 0 to capital K. Then we again find the successive dilation operation, and at last we take the union of the dilated result here. So finally we get the skeleton here. Now the first column that just now we have shown you has all the original sets at the top and the two erosions by the structuring element using the B. So one more erosion of A would yield the empty set, so that K is equal to 2 in this particular case. The second column shows that the opening of the sets in the first column by the same structuring element B here. These results are easily explained by the fitting characterization of the opening operation into the next column. The next and the fourth column contains the two partial skeletons and the final result here. The final skeletons not only is the thicker one than it needs to be, but more important as it is not connected. So this is the result that is not unexpected, as nothing in the preceding formulation of the morphological skeleton guarantees the connectivity of the regions here. The morphologically, we have production of an elegant formulation in terms of erosion and opening for the given set. However, the heuristic formulations are needed if, as is usually the case, the skeleton must be maximally thin, connected and minimally eroded there. So the fifth column shows that S suffix 0 of A, S suffix 1 of A dilated by B and S suffix 2 of A dilated by B for the two successive steps there. Finally, the last column shows the reconstruction of the set A, which according to the equation number 5 is the union of the dilated skeleton subsets shown in the fifth column. So I hope we have completely addressed the skeletons using the examples. By the next lecture, we shall be addressing the next topic for understanding of morphological image processing. The title of the topic is pruning. For more information and knowledge of the subject, you can subscribe to Ikeda channel. Thank you.